We know that being aligned to your chosen reality is the easiest and quickest way to get to said chosen reality. And we know in this community, we all work every single day to keep ourselves in alignment and aligned to our chosen reality. But what do we do when we are out of alignment, and how do we recognize that? That is what we're discussing in this episode of Roxy Talks. Stay tuned. What is up, my fellow dreamers and soul searchers? Welcome to another episode of Roxy Talks, where we discuss confidence, mindset, manifestation, and more. My name is Roxy Lee. I'm a mindset coach, and I'm here to help you banish your negative thinking and limiting beliefs so you can bring love, clarity, and joy into your life. If you are looking to get yourself in and stay in alignment, check out my 30 Days of Alignment Challenge. It is what actually helped me change my entire life and get everything I needed to do in order so that I could begin becoming the person that I am now, frankly. You can check out my 30 Days of Alignment Challenge at my website, roxytalks.com. I've got a free version and an upgraded version where I guide you through the whole process with 30 days worth of videos. Both will help you get to where you need to go. I've also got exclusive merch, podcasts, and more at my website, roxytalks.com, including other courses, workshops, and coaching. And I've just launched my brand new style channel where I go behind the scenes of every look that you see here on Roxy Talks, including this. Crazy. I don't know. She's a little bit Prince. She's a little bit Benjamin Franklin. She's a little bit Diane Keaton somehow. I don't know. We're just going with it, but you'll get to see how I put this look together and where I got the pieces and my inspiration for it on my brand new Roxy Talks style channel. Be sure to subscribe. The link to that channel is below. You can also join me on social media. I'm on TikTok, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Now, before we get into this video, please hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell so you never miss an update. And if you're feeling generous, please like and share. That helps us reach as many people as possible, and everyone deserves to know that they are in complete control of their reality. Now, we've talked a lot about alignment here on this channel. Obviously, I have the 30 Days of Alignment Challenge, and again, I've said this a million times, but it is what helped me change my life. It really did get me in a space where I could overhaul my entire life, and I did. And once I got through the 30 days, I just kept going. And eventually I stumbled upon my own personal practice, the 360 method. I'll link it above if you haven't seen that video. And now my days are spent making sure that I stay in alignment. Now that I know what I'm doing, now that I can kind of do it without trying, I still do have to try, at least, to stay focused. Like, that's where we try. We don't try to manifest. We try to stay focused. We do. There's no try, there's only do, right? So we do succeed, we do focus, but that is where we put our attention, is on our own personal thought process, not necessarily all over our manifestation. We need to just make sure that we're not undoing our manifestations when we go out and about in our regular lives. So being in alignment, what does that mean? Let's take 24 hours. Let's take one whole day. If you were able to only think thoughts that coincide with or match up to or would exist in your chosen reality for 24 hours straight, you only think those types of thoughts, then you will spend 24 hours aligned to or matched up to or operating within, navigating from your chosen reality. And the longer you exist in your chosen reality upstairs, the faster and easier you are able to live it downstairs in your regular life, in your 3D world. So that means that when you're out of alignment, obviously you are thinking a thought. Let's just break this down right in the moment. When you're out of alignment, you are thinking a thought that does not belong in your chosen reality. You guys remember Sesame Street? One of these things is not like the other. So if you are thinking a thought that does not match up to or would not exist in your chosen reality, then you are by default no longer aligned to your chosen reality. For example, if you are working on manifesting a person and you are thinking about the fact that they cheated or that it's hard or that you miss them or you don't know if you're ever going to be with anybody again or if you're going to be single forever or does anybody like you or anything like that, if you are thinking that, those thoughts do not exist in or line up to or match up to a reality where you are happy, healthy, whole in your relationship. Those are not the kind of things that people in happy, healthy, whole relationships think about. It's just not what they think about. I can tell you that personally. I'm in a happy, healthy, whole relationship, and you know what I think about? Work. I don't really think about my relationship much because it's all good. It's handling itself. It's on autopilot in a good way. For me, we've set it and forget it. It's good to go. I just exist within it, enjoy myself with my husband, maybe script about maybe one sentence a week. Literally, I rarely, rarely, rarely ever script about my relationship because I don't really have to personally. So for the most part, I'm not thinking thoughts that are out of alignment with my relationship, and I'm in a great, happy marriage. So I can just tell you, as somebody who has gotten their SP and has succeeded through that, my thoughts about my relationship are very rare. I'm really not usually thinking about that because it's not something that that's taking up my mental capacity. Yes, he takes up physical space in my world and it's great and I enjoy my time with him, but if I'm not hanging out with him and talking to him or whatever, I'm working. I'm thinking about me. I'm thinking about where I'm going next. I'm thinking about what outfit I'm going to wear in my next week of shows. Like, that's where my mind is, because having a productive relationship, you are not consumed with it all day. So there's a tip for you guys. If you are working on manifesting a relationship and you are consumed all day long, not exactly the right energy. Now, of course, you know, as long as you're thinking thoughts of abundance and gratitude and appreciation and affirming that what you have is already here, that's definitely okay and definitely much better than thinking thoughts of absence and lack and doubt and worry. But either way, my point is, just understand that people who are in healthy relationships and happy with their partners are not obsessed with it all day long. So just something to think about, some food for thought. So how do you recognize when you're out of alignment? Well, I just gave you one answer. Your thoughts don't match up. If your thoughts sound worrisome, doubtful, fearful, lackful, insecurityful, they are not part of your chosen reality. I hope, right? We really hope they're not. So that's one indication. That's a huge red flag. Your thoughts don't sound like they would if you had what you wanted, obviously, right? Well, not everybody notices those things. So what other ways can you check? If you are reacting to your 3D, you're not in alignment with your chosen reality. If you're gossiping about what's going on in your world, you're not in alignment with your chosen reality. If you are taking digs at yourself or someone else, you're not in your chosen reality. And these types of things happen immediately. They happen so quickly, most people don't even realize they're doing them. This is something I catch people doing a lot in coaching, is we'll talk about something, we'll declare something, we'll have a new idea, we'll rewrite a story, and immediately, within seconds, they go back to a, why can't it work? How come this? Yeah, but it's not. If only I could. Oh, but I wish. Those are powerful. You know those annoying affirmations that we just fire off? Yeah, I'll have a Pepsi or whatever. And then you get a Pepsi and it's like, why would that manifest when I give zero fucks about it? I don't care. I don't care about a Pepsi. I thought about it for half a second and now it came an hour later. What the hell? I think about my SP all day and they're nowhere to be found. Well, right there is its own manifestation. That's a definition right there. But the issue is that, for one, you don't really care enough to counteract a Pepsi. It's not that big of a deal. You don't care if you do or don't have it. It's not life or death. It's not do or die. It doesn't really make a difference. You know that you'll be fine with or without it. And if you don't have one now, you'll just get one later, right? It's not a big deal. It's not a big deal. You don't have opposing thoughts to it. You're not sitting there thinking, but what if I don't get my Pepsi? Am I going to be thirsty all day? Like, is someone going to give me one for free? I don't have any change. I don't know how I could even get one. I'm so thirsty. I don't even know what I'm going to do. That's potentially adding opposition or potentially pushing it away. But when you just send it off and there's no opposition to it, it doesn't have to go through all the red tape that your manifestations that you keep sending off and unsending and 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 sending off. Those ones, well, those have a lot of red tape all over them. They got to go through a bunch of people because you've been sending them back and forth. They got all kinds of stamps on them, been through a bunch of customs. We don't know where it's going. It's craziness. The other one, you just sent a quick email, send, done. I'm not really worried about it. It's easier to get done because it goes right to the front of the line. There's no recheck. There's no question. There's no random TSA check. It's just right to the front of the line. There's no opposition to it. Now, the messed up part is the same thing happens when you fire off the little things, or the those, like, yeah, but it's those little declarative sentences that we think are just cute and you're being self-deprecating and it's okay and it doesn't really matter. Those things have just as much power as, yeah, I'll have a Pepsi. Yeah, maybe I'll see a white dog today. Those things that you just don't care about, you fire them off, they never cross your mind again. The same thing happens when you are saying oppositional shit to your manifestations. Yeah, but he doesn't call yet. Yeah, but it's still been a long time. Yeah, but we're still no contact. Okay, but sure, right? We don't need to say that. You don't need to let anybody in on that fact. Keep that to yourself. Because those little things that you don't realize you're firing off all day long have no red tape because you're not undoing them. You're undoing the manifestation by saying that stuff. But if you don't go back in and undo that thing right away, it's one of those easy, quick manifestations, and we know those ones happen and come to us fast. So if you want to be in alignment, make sure that you are not constantly taking yourself out of it, even with the tiniest little phrases. Another way to tell that you're out of alignment, obviously, is you don't really feel peaceful anymore. Maybe unease, dread, fear, worry, doubt, insecurity, even just a little bit of uncomfortability, annoyance, apathy, things that do not line up to, you know what, life is amazing, I'm grateful for everything I have, let's have some more. It's easy to pinpoint if you're paying attention, right? I always say awareness and discipline, they're required because you've got to know what you're doing in your mind. And you've got to be willing to change it when you catch yourself doing something not on the approved thought list. It's not on the approved content. This isn't a pre-approved thought. This doesn't fit the mold. This doesn't add up to or fit into the reality that we want to be in. So therefore, it does not get to get attention. If I catch myself thinking thoughts like this, I shut them down and I redirect myself to something that is better, something that does or would exist in my chosen reality. And I do it every time. And I mean every time. I don't know how many times I've said every time and I still talk to clients and they're like, oh, you really mean like every time? I'm like, how else can I say it? How else can I say every fucking thought you have? That one and then that one and then that one and then that one too and then that one and that one and that one too. And the one where you just said, oh, but that one too. And then the one time when you said, oh, but that, no, that too. And then the one time you said, yeah, but it's been a long time. That one too. All of them. I don't say it for fun. I don't say it for hyperbole. I say it to be real and honest with you. All of your thoughts are manifesting. Fucking act like it. That's it. Think about it like this. Let's say that there is a brand new vegan restaurant down Main Street. Never been there, but I know it exists. And I cannot wait to go sink my teeth into some delicious vegan food. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my feet on Main Street and I'm going to walk in the direction of the restaurant. Let's just say west. All right. We're going to go west on Main Street. And what I'm going to keep doing is putting one foot in front of the other continuously over and over until I reach my destination. Never been there before, but I'm going to get there. I know I am because I'm on the path to it and I'm moving forward. There's no other option. Now, as I'm on Main Street, not only am I going to reach the restaurant that I want to be at, I'm also going to see everything else that Main Street has to offer. Everything else that goes along with that reality. If it's on Main Street, if it's a Main Street thought or a Main Street experience, if it matches up to or aligns with my chosen reality, then I will experience it as long as I stay on Main Street. It's an inevitability. I could not if I tried. The only way I wouldn't experience that thing on Main Street is if I stopped going down Main Street. Okay, so let's say that I do. Let's say that I take a hard ride on Elm Street. Let's say that I find myself in a nightmare on Elm Street and everything looks really scary all of a sudden. The houses are dark and the grass is brown and there's like loose raccoons all over the place and all of a sudden the skies get dark and you're like, oh shit, this shit's haunted. You know what I'm talking about, right? Like scary movie. And now that I'm on Elm Street, I'm going to see everything that Elm Street has to offer and nothing that Main Street has to offer because it is physically impossible for me to see a single building experience, sidewalk, rock, street light, doesn't matter, that exists on Main Street while I am on Elm Street. There is no physical way, right? So what I'm going to have to do then, if I catch myself on Elm Street, is turn my ass back around and get back onto Main Street. That's the only way. And once I'm back on Main Street, all I have to do is continue to put my feet forward in the direction of where I want to go. And the way we do that is thought by thought. Think about every single one of your thoughts as a footstep. Every single one of your thoughts is a footstep and it is leading you somewhere. And if it's not leading you down Main Street, then you are not going to see what is down Main Street. That's there's how could you? How could you? Okay. So if you are not on Main Street, if you are not thinking thoughts that align with your chosen reality, if you are thinking in ways that limit yourself, that harm you, that put you down, that put you at neutral, that put you below people, they don't work. Those are not Main Street thoughts. Those are Elm Street thoughts. And if you want to see everything that Main Street has to offer, you have got to get your ass off Elm Street. And every single solitary time you catch yourself trying to turn down Elm Street, you make yourself stop. And I mean every time. I'm not fucking joking. I don't have time to just tell you pretty little phrases. When I say something, I mean it. I'm trying to find the most plain English words that I can use. Smallest amount of syllables, shortest words, most direct explanation. Every single thought must be paid attention to. If not, they're going to slip by. So, if you really want to find out what's going on and why you're out of alignment or why you're not at your thing, blah, 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 blah. You got to pay attention to these things. Notice when you're thinking thoughts that don't match up. Notice when you're on Elm Street and you're not on Main Street. Get yourself back on Main Street every single time. Even if you're turning around in circles for an hour, it does not matter as long as you end back up on Main Street every time, forever, for the rest of your life. It never ends. It never ends. It never fucking ends, okay? So I want you to comment down below. I'm super in tune with my thoughts. I'm super in tune with my thoughts because I want you to start affirming that you pay attention, affirming that you're really good at it, even if you're not, even if it's the last thing you do, even if you're fucking spiraling all day and you're not catching yourself, start now. Otherwise, why are you watching this channel? Why are you watching these videos if you're not going to do the work? Oh, you know what? Hey, that's a great segue for tomorrow. Tomorrow's video is about doing the work and what that means. So check back tomorrow if that's not here above. It will be after tomorrow's video. Just kidding. It's Thursday's video because tomorrow's video is actually going to be on my style channel where I will be breaking down this look and showing you guys how I put together the Roxy Talks image for every episode. I swear to God, those segues just fucking wrote themselves. I must be in alignment. If you'd like to get into alignment, download my 30 Days of Alignment Challenge. It is actually what helped me change my entire life. I'm not joking about that. I don't have time to fucking bullshit you guys. This is what happened. I fucking got my shit together. I did it using that 30 Days of Alignment, and I'm still doing the practices. So if you want to get your shit handled, check out my 30 Days of Alignment Challenge. Free version, upgraded version. The upgraded version, I guide you through it with 30 days worth of videos. Both are great and will absolutely get you to where you need to go. You can check out both of those at my website, roxytalks.com. I've also got other courses, workshops, and coaching to help you get to the bottom of your specific situation. That's all at my website, roxytalks.com, as well as podcasts and exclusive merch. And if you're interested in how I put my looks together, make sure you subscribe to Roxy Talk Style. I've got videos out every Wednesday on that channel at 11:30 a.m. PST. You can also join me on social media. I'm on TikTok, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. And don't forget to join my Facebook group, Black Moon Society. It's a great community for like-minded people who are helping each other manifest. Here on the Roxy Talks channel, we go live every Monday at noon-ish PST for Q&A. And I've got brand new videos out 3 times a week. So make sure you subscribe and hit the bell notification so you never miss an update. And if you're feeling generous, please like and share. That helps us reach as many people as possible. And everyone deserves to know that they are in complete control of their reality. We're all raising our vibrations together. You have the power. I believe in you.